Right, now last week we had the head wobblers.
Right, which was a disgrace.
This is the pre-season head wobblers, of which it gave us all great delight to see our man, the lone wolf, the number one. Because he's been, I thought you'd been light on him for the last couple of years. He hasn't copped anywhere near as much as he should.
He hit me with a double serving last week.
So you copped the doubler and you deserved it and you're now the golden trumpet holder.
I know. There's been a lot of nominations, but I'm probably once a month, I reckon, is enough to go with it. Because you need to see, you know, the media.
I've got six or seven that are going to take the trumpet off me next time you go.
Well, one of the men you slipped into the top 10 was our great friend, the V8 supercar driver, Jason Barguana. And you said, I think, about Craig Hutchison that he had sat on a gas outlet, I think was your words.
Well, he trained off a little bit over the summer.
Well, Hutchie works on another station. It's off Broadway.
AFL Live.
Joint. And but what he did, as we understand today,
he hasn't retaliated.
Well, what I understand,
he would have taken it.
He gave you 10 of his best minutes. Sharpest minutes from Barguana. And Spud, let's just hear the closing 30 seconds.
In total, the editor-in-chief Danny Frawley has managed to find in the Coaches Association annual report 23 Danny Frawley favourable mentions.
In how many pages?
Five glossy colour photos of himself.
How many pages? I assume this was a 100, 200 page report.
No, it's like just a little 24 page little manual.
Am I allowed to actually mention the word me? Or has he got a patent on that? So, because that sounds to me, that smacks to me of me time.
So I put it this way. From now on, let's not put out the coach's report. Next year, Danny Frawley, this is your bloody life, we'll call it. That's a disgrace, Spud. Oh, what a damn puff piece.
A little bit of wobbling going on.
Now, fair to say, not a funny one.
That's
but
the first I've heard of it. I tell you what, as funny as a kick in the pills, Hutchie.
So, now, I believe he spent a week on that.
Well, if he spent a week
that was
on
just
that,
the last bit, to be fair to me. We had to just take the little bit at the end.
I'm a new age person, had a near fatal accident on the bike last year. I'm not going to react because I think at times you need to deny things of oxygen. The best way to kill it is just choke it.
So
deny it of oxygen.
The great man that I know, the most competitive being I know, is just going to wear that.
I'm just going to wear that. I just think sometimes you've just got to accept that maybe I went overboard a little bit last week.
What about...
This is extraordinary.
Okay, that means I'm going to line you up then, if this is the way you're going to cop them.
It's my understanding that, well, from what I just heard, it wasn't only Barguana. I thought I heard Pickers involved, and I thought a little bit of turf might have been in there as well.
I
think you're right. Stuff it. No! They can get stuffed. Because I tell you, it's just come to me. Hutchie is the face of Celebrity Slim for him. Now, I've led to believe Slater and Gordon,
look at him,
Celebrity Slim for him,
warming up now.
Celebrity Slim for him have used Slater and Gordon to sort of just go behind the scenes and explore how their money's been spent. Now, what they had to do, Slater and Gordon, they had to wear hard hats, full metal jackets and goggles. Why? Because old Hutchie is still wearing last year's suits. Now, he did sit on the gas barbecue, and the buttons on his suit and shirts are at a breaking strain of 300 PSI. Now, hence, Slater and Gordon wear the full hard hats, full metal jackets, and goggles. Because I tell you what, boys, if one of those buttons come off, it is occupational health and safety at its best. It will be ricochet off wall to wall. And I tell you, do not go near Craig Hutchison. And as for Pickers, chortling to use Sammy Newman's in the background and bit of me. I tell you what, Pickers, I'm not going to tell you. I don't think anyone should about the hair, mate. But I tell you what, the feather's on top, mate. It's time to let him go. There's a couple just hanging in there at the top, and he's fluffing them up a bit. Time for the juddy. Just get rid of him.
Shave.
Just get rid of him.
Oh,
it's embarrassing.
Come on,
it.
It's not that bad, Danny.
It is. No, I'm going to leave Dr. Turf alone because I'm not sure who he is. But
Hutchie,
I've heard he's got a big bugle. I'm not going to. Nah, Gary White, I said I wasn't going to get personal.
I applauded
that's
it. I thought you'd
but
turn
once
over
a month, I'll tell you what, I'm getting a lot of people come to me.
Yes.
I'm not going to put anyone's name in, but I'll tell you what, some of the texts I've been getting lately is I just can't run with it every week.
Well,
I don't think
I've
got it
this,
in me.
But if I ever end up in your wobble again, then we're...
Mate. I must be honest. One of the texts was about you, and I'm going to let it ride. I don't know the full facts of it. I'm not running with it.
That's never worried you before.
Not me.
I'm not running with it.
The less facts you deal with, the better in your office.
They're all
but
true.
I'd like you to work it into something.
I think 4 weeks, like the Saints, we need just to see an equilibrium about the media people.
I think every 2 weeks.
I think the golden flute might come out in a couple of weeks. That's for the...
I've got that at home. I'll bring it
out.
No,
they're the up-and-comers. You know, this is the guys just starting out.
Not the Trump.
They just get a little bit of a glint in the eyes. They look down the lens, you know, and the microphone.
What I liked, Damo, was how long it took from Spud to say, I'm not saying anything, to a personal full-fronted attack.
It was the longest period of time it took.
I probably did get personally, but I'm not taking it back. He can get stuffed.
Well, we effectively said, as I understand it, as Damo filled me in, that you wrote a report and that you made sure that you were mentioned about 80 times saying how good a job you did.
Is there any truth in this?
There were a few references, Danny.
There probably is, but I didn't do the report.
Well, he said that you're signed off on it.
But a lot of people got interviewed, but anyway.
Can I move? Chairman, can I move a motion that the Golden Trumpet gets handed over to Spuds for putting out a magazine with 30 mentions of himself?
I have patented it, Gary. Don't go down Hutchie Street. Okay.
25 mentions, 5 glossy photos.
Oh, that Golden Trumpet worthy. That has to be Golden Trumpet worthy.
It probably is.
It is.
But I can't give it to myself.
I'll give it to you.
I tell you, I must admit. Craig Hutchison's got too much bloody time in his hands to be read that whole report. But for God's sake, give me a spell.